Welcome to episode number one of the Sawse. We've got Nick with Hangar 24 and Armen with Left Coast.
Did you? Late. Maybe you were tired.
Yeah, tired of winning. <'cause> we won.
Yeah, we know about the Nick and fucking beer pong. Oh God! Go ahead, show us the Beaver.
No.
Nick with Hangar 24. Is that better? There we go. You good? Rob's gonna go out and grab Nick. We'll ask him some questions, figure out what's going on with his beer. We just tapped one of his new beers today, so we're gonna get him in here and get him mic'd up and get rolling. Yeah, you're on camera.
I have a new idea.
What?
I think you should do bathroom quote of the week.
Bathroom quote of the week.
Yeah.
Why?
Because if you go in the bathroom and you look around, like, there's some cool things that are written on chalk that, like, should be publicized.
That's going to work for the women's, because women are cool, but the men write a bunch of shit.
So don't bring anything from the men's bathroom. Bring it from the women's bathroom. There's an amazing Hemingway quote in the women's bathroom right now.
She wants to do a quote of the week.
Bathroom quote of the week.
But if you look at the women's bathroom, it's like pink and flowers and everybody writing cool shit.
No, there's shit that goes down. There really is shit that goes
down. And in the men's, it's like, check out my big whatever and fucking...
Yeah, don't look down.
I pissed here. I wiped here.
Yeah. No, there's some good stuff. There really is.
Yeah, to make sure.
I can show you the girls' restroom. There's a great Hemingway quote that talks about, like, yeah, tomorrow comes, but what you do today affects tomorrow. It's like... amazing.
All that you just said, I would never listen to. Only because I like
lies. All right, drop that sucker down your shirt.
Really?
Mic up.
We're being mic up.
Yep.
Test 1, 2, test 1, 2.
You got him?
Rock and roll.
Pop that on your pocket or whatever. Where'd my phone go?
See me fuck up, and then you can do yours perfect. There you go.
Can we get some beers,
Red Wings?
Yeah.
I'm mic'd up, dude.
Let's do, you already got one? Let's do 3 24s for right now. Yeah.
We all wore Red Wings.
Why?
I close every
crazy.
Oh, man.
I had black ones.
Sorry, dude. It's good seeing you, man. It's good seeing you. Yeah.
Steel toes.
How you doing?
Awesome.
Good to see you, man. How are you?
Oh, you guys.
We've got Nick with Hangar 24 here. We've got the new beer 24, right?
Correct, yeah, 24.
So tell us a little bit about 24.
So, you know, Hangar hasn't released a core beer brand in a couple years now. Core beer meaning that it's going to be year-round. It's going to be available basically forever almost, per se. So we, being Orange Wheat, our flagship beer, awesome meat, lies eat, you know, easy drinking beer. We wanted to make something else to kind of go perfect with it. And what else but make a blonde? Blonde's a gateway beer in craft beer, basically meaning someone, if you're not really familiar with craft beer, you want to try one, hey, let's try a blonde. Why? It's easy, it's light, it's crisp. And that's exactly what we did with 24. We use whole true hops, just a little bit hint of bitterness at the end, almost give it a crisp ending. It's gonna do really well, especially in the heat. And I'm excited for it. We haven't been this more pumped in, I mean, years. We launched this in 3 states on Friday, and it's gonna be here full time.
Awesome. Well, we're excited to have it here at Stackz. I know the customers are gonna love it, so let's give it a shot.
Absolutely.
What do we got here?
Cheers.
Cheers.
Yep.
That goes down smooth.
Light, easy body, perfect carbonation, not too sweet. That's a good thing with blonde, that, you know, sometimes they're overly sweet, you can have more than one, but this one doesn't have that. You want to drink more, you want to keep drinking it. You know what I mean? It's the best thing about it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's good. Right on. Oh, yeah. Well, thanks for bringing it down. We appreciate
Absolutely.
It. Absolutely. What's going on with Hangar these days? What's new? I know you guys got AirFest coming up.
AirFest, yeah. AirFest is our biggest event we throw on every year. It's going to be May 20th, that weekend right there. We have thousands of people show up, hundreds of vendors, and it sells out every year. And we are in the works of two this year, which is the first. So
two of them,
yes.
Oh, shit.
So we did open a new location on Lake Havasu, and that might be our second AirFest.
Oh, that would be sick.
So that would be the next one. Yeah, so AirFest tickets are on sale right now. You can actually start purchasing those. That's definitely
And that's
an event
in, I think, like 52 days or something like that?
Yeah, it's super close.
I was looking at the countdown.
May 20th. We are literally less than 2 weeks out. So we are ready to go with that. I haven't been myself, but I heard it's insane because we work it.
Yeah,
so
for sure.
So that's definitely something to check out.
We plan on going this year.
Yeah, definitely.
So a lot of vendors, a lot of food.
A lot of vendors, a lot of beer. I mean, geez, beers, that's what we are.
So bunch of planes.
Bunch of planes. We're going to have a couple fighter jets coming out this year, which is really cool. That's going to do that. Kid friendly, which is great. And like I said, more beer than you can drink.
Right on. So if you guys are in town, go down and check out the AirFest.
AirFest.
Over at Hangar 24 in Redlands, California at the airport. That'd be awesome.
Right.
I can't wait to go. I haven't been. She's been. Where'd she go? My wife's been, obviously. I have not. So
yeah,
can't wait to get out
there. It's crazy time. It's a good time, though, especially out in the open. Heat, beer, food, it's all you need. So.
Sick. So anything coming up in the works with any new beers?
Works,
anything
going on? So we're changing up this year a little bit, which is great. It's more for the better. We have, basically seven new beers coming out. And the next one that we're coming out that I'm personally excited for is going to be our vanilla orange wheat on nitro. Kind of a 50-50 bar beer. Orange cream, nitro brings cream to a beer.
Yeah.
So there's a little bit of vanilla bean in there with the orange wheat itself. Yum. I'm excited for that. We're releasing a new beer called Orange Wedge. It's going to be a blood orange grapefruit IPA that I'm really pumped for. Use local fruit, of course. And those are the two that I'm kind of hope that's going to be in the next couple of weeks or so.
Nice. Yeah. Cool. Do you have any questions, Rob?
No, I'm good.
All good. Rob's always good. Let's roll into the introduction of Left Coast.
You guys
turned us on to Left Coast.
Yeah.
People love their Unamas. Mm-hmm. So let's talk a little bit about Unamas. Actually, I'm going to down my beer and grab Unamas.
Sounds good. Yeah, so we distribute six other breweries as well of ourselves, and Left Coast is one of our breweries you pick up. And we brought on Unamas and Trestles by them, one of their couple flagship beers. And like I said, huge success. Unamas is literally mean wanting one more, and that's what we're doing here. So it's awesome.
Cool. Armen, come on over. Dude, appreciate it.
Absolutely. Rob, you're a killer interviewer. Totally fucking played me, huh?
So do a test real quick. Are you getting...
Hello.
You getting them?
Good.
Cool. All right, so Armen, thank you for coming down,
No problem.
I appreciate it.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you very much. So, San Clemente.
Yep.
Left Coast. We've got Unamas on tap. We've got Trestles on tap. They've both done very well, so we brought them back for pint night again tonight.
Yep.
Tell us a little bit about Left Coast.
Left Coast is a family-run company. We've been around about 8 years as a brewery. And we've been improving ever since. That's right. One thing we're trying to tell everyone is, like, you may have had us before, but we're always revamping our beers, always making them better to make them compete. So if you haven't had Left Coast in a long time, I'd try it again. You'll be surprised.
Yeah, for sure. I just talked to my wife about it. She said, San Clemente, Left Coast, we can go there. It's close. Yeah. She wants to go down. She loves the beach and she loves beer. So
we're just about 2 miles off the coast. So.
And she just mentioned that the train goes right to there. So if you guys are in Rancho Cucamonga area or in this area, jump on the Metrolink, get right over to Left Coast.
Yep.
Right on. So I've heard a couple things about Left Coast. You guys have a beer club, right?
Yep.
Okay. Tell us a little bit about beer club. How's that work?
Basically, it's a yearly fee. So, I'm not sure about the price. I know it's more tasting room side, but basically, you just pay a fee, and then you get access to rare bottles, you get kegs, and pints at discounts. So it's basically just to help the locals be part of it. But I think there's a waiting list.
Gotcha.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Cool. Yeah, we're gonna have to get down there and check it out. I just finished my 24, so I'm gonna see if I could summons a Unamas. Alma, can you bring, do you want an Unamas?
Yeah.
Unamas? Can you bring a couple, you want one?
No, I got a trust.
Okay. Two Unamases.
I'll make it easy. I am doing it.
right, so cool. So give us a rundown about the beers that you've brought in tonight.
So the Uno Mas is our amber lager. It's styled after Mexican-style amber lagers. Really easy drinking, nice copper color. You get a nice malt finish, but super easy drinking, perfect for a hot day. It's like, so I think it's like a perfect summer beer.
Yeah. Cool.
And the second one is Trestles, named after the surf spot down in San Clemente.
Yeah, Trestles. Yeah. I didn't even put two and two together, but obviously.
I'd say it's a textbook IPA. It's, when you think IPA, that's how it should taste. It's not too bitter, not like a lot of them that people can't drink. It's very well balanced. It's only about 60 IBU, so it's not crazy bitter, but it's still something hopheads like, something people who want to try an IPA will enjoy too, because it's not overpowering with any other. But it's one of my personal favorites. I can drink it all the time.
Cool. Well, we're about to get a taste right now.
Two and a half for you guys.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Cheers.
But you get a nice malt kind of finish, but it's not too heavy.
Definitely. Very smooth. Love that. Check out that glass. Can you get that in the shot? So, speaking of the glass, every Thursday night from 6 to 9, 10 o'clock, we're having Pint Night here at Stackz. So you come down and get that brew of choice with the branded glass, and you can take that glass home with you. So come down on Thursday nights, check it out. Every week we'll be doing this show with these guys so we can talk about the beer, get to know the beer, see what's going on, talk about the brewery. That's a good beer, man. Robbie, you have any questions for these guys?
Good.
All good. Always good.
Yep.
Thanks right, for coming down, man.
Thanks for having
Appreciate
us.
Appreciate it. Right on.
Hey, thanks for that handle.
Love it.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
totally, everything you guys have ever done has been wood, right?
Everything.
And now this is the first swap. Yeah.
And I love, you see the off-centered of 24, it literally catches your eye. No matter what handle you're looking at, you see that. Even next to that big-ass Trestles handle. It's, you know what I mean?
You know what? It does. Like I told you the other day, it reminded me of like a postage stamp. The way they're branding it, like it's not perfect. You know, it is what it is.
Yeah.
It looks,
I like it.
It
like
looks
a
cool.
A little bit of that raw look, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I dig it.
And it's heavy too. When you handed it to me, it was heavy.
Me and Rob were like, you could do damage with it. You really could, dude. I told her, I guess she said one time her handle snapped in there the head. I'm like, if that hits you, you're going down. Dude.
Yeah.
You're going to be out for the count.
Well, if it snaps, it's going to break our calf.
That's not it. So I was like, hey, be careful when you pull that. Don't pull from the top. Pull from the bottom. Everything pull from the bottom. Yeah.
That might be making noise while you play with it.
Sorry. Sorry.
Was it making noise when he was playing with it? A little bit? Katie.
Katie.
All right, you're on camera.
Why?
Here, hold that. No, put that on you.
If I could figure it out.
Did you try the beers?
Yes, I did.
Which ones did you try?
I tried both the Uno Mas and the Trestles, and then the Hangar.
What was your favorite? What'd you like?
I always go for the Hangar. I love Hangar.
You're like my wife.
Yes. But the Trestles was also really good. I like that one better than Uno Mas, no offense. But it's still yours.
That's what we're
doing. Still yours.
That's right.
Yeah, no, the Trestles, it has a little bit more, I guess the hops in it are a little bit, they're not too out there.
Yeah.
But the Uno Mas, it almost was a little bit flatter to me than the Trestles was. So the Trestles had a better taste to me.
Yeah.
And the Hangar's always on point, so I can't complain.
For those of you that don't know, Katie was an ex-employee, or she was an employee, and she comes back for the Pint Nights every once in a while, right?
Yeah.
Thank you, Katie.
It's because I love beer. Can't hate
no, it's
it.
Not. You know you forgot you ever hang out with
me. That too. You're my favorite. Oh, I didn't know if we were going to chit-chat.
I like how Rob spelled Hangar wrong. That's my favorite
Did
part.
You?
Oh, shit.
It's Hangar, but coat Hangar. H-A-R.
That's all right.
Oh, we're going to get that on camera.
I don't know who that hair is going for. It's got to be a copyright.
You sat right there and watched me do that.
I did. That was a bad angle. Oh, shit.
Cool. Well, thanks for coming in, Katie. You guys taking off?
No, we're eating. His parents came.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah.
Oh, these are his parents right here?
Yeah.
Awesome.
His dad looks like.
Looks like he's his brother?
Yeah.
Thanks, Katie. What's up, man? How you doing? Good to see you.
What's up, man?
What are you drinking? Hold on. What are you drinking?
I don't know. Katie got it.
Whatever Katie told me to do.
Not the Uno Mas, the other one.
Trestles. Trestles? Yeah. What do you think?
It's good. I like
good?
It.
Good? Right on. Yeah.
Gotta try the other one next.
For sure.
This question, so funny from the last rep that was here before, is it just been 110% turnaround?
Dude, hold on.
I've been asking that a couple times. I'm glad
that you reversed the question asking, because let me get this on camera. The difference is night and day.
Cool.
Like, first rep, Rick, amazing. The dude came in here, he was always on point, always here when he said he was gonna be, always taking care of us, always making sure the orders were good. But then after he moved on and did something else.
Did another route, yeah.
Something happened, whatever the fuck. But then when he left, it all fucking went downhill. It all tanked. Yeah. And then you got back involved, and it's been better than before. So
that's good.
I mean, dude, we appreciate everything that you've been doing. It's been amazing. Seriously.
I don't know. I know we're wrapping some trucks in 24, though, which we should be. Sponsored a... You know, like the trucks that race for NASCAR, the trucks, instead of the cars. We have a car wrapped in 24, so that's gonna be cool. Derek Robertson Stroller, he's gonna be doing this. He's gonna be a 24 sponsor.
Is it the whole season?
Whole season.
Wow.
Yeah, he'll have his car over at events and stuff in the parking lot. You know, start up the car and all that cool shit. So that'll be cool. Cool stuff coming, man. Just gotta. I'm waiting for it, you know what I mean?
You need to suck up to the owner, maybe we can park the car out front and have
no shit. Yeah. I know, I was thinking like, right there outside the street, we'll put some easy ups up, get some cornhole outside in the parking lot.
Yeah.
That'd be cool. Do games involved. That's the biggest thing, I think. If they're like, what was one more thing that every brewery should do at an event is games. There's not one thing you can do. Hey, I'm Nick, I'm from Hangar. Cool, you like that? That's great, cool. Hey, you wanna go play beer pong? I'll beat your ass. No, fuck you, I'll beat your ass. Like, that's way better to me than anything. I like that more. I think it's more involvement, you drink more.
Yeah, we know about the Nick and fucking beer pong.
We played all the time with Nick, he's too infused. I
rules change to get
Yeah, you just don't mess around, dude. It's a game, we're gonna win, you know what I mean?
But I think you lost.
I
think no, he lost with me.
But him and I played against you and Sara, and we won.
We won. I think Katie.
Wait a second, Sara, come here.
Yeah, we. I think.
Hold on.
No, we beat them. I remember being pretty bad.
Didn't you and I play Nick and somebody else in beer pong and kick their ass?
No. We beat you guys. Remember?
I know.
Oh no. No.
Yeah.
I beat you, and you were so sad.
No, that's not me.
Yes.
I'm not
a
poor sport.
Hey, Nick. Yes. No, you were a poor sport. You were righteous. You were righteous.
And I'm pretty sure I made the last shot.
I don't know who made the last shot, but I know that you just didn't cut it this time.
No, I don't think so.
Well, then I say it's a rematch.
A fine deal. Next game.
Alma, get the cup.
Late. Maybe you were tired.
Sure, we'll go with that.
Okay.
Sorry.
Tired of winning.
Did you have 24 or what'd you drink? Oh no, you had
both.
The Namaste.
I actually had both.
Yeah.
And I liked it. Well, I'm a true heart Hangar lover.
We know.
So.
And Nick loves you.
That's my number one.
Drinker.
But I actually really like Uno Mas.
Yeah.
I do.
Uno Mas is good.
It is. It's really good.
We actually, when we ran out, we had a lot of customers ask them to bring it.
Yeah. A ton.
Oh, I did. Yeah. I saw that posted. I was like, oh, dang, I'm going to have to check this out. And bathroom quote of the week.
So now you need to do your
bathroom quotes.
Yep.
Girls, I'll say girls bathroom quotes.
That's better, because I guarantee you walk in that bathroom.
See, you agree, right?
Oh, fuck. Really
dude.
You go in the guy's bathroom?
Like, every once in a while, the men's...
I don't go in the girls.
Yeah, we can.
Hold on. Every once in a while, the men's is locked.
Yeah.
So I run into the girls, and I'm just like...
Because my coworker got her card, so...
Just like, looking around, like, holy shit, dudes are fucking disgusting.
It's true.
It would be part of his business to promote. All these other people.
I walked in and there was flowers.
No one,
this
one seems like
written in cursive quotes.
I love you.
There was a cool one that's by the mirror that said, like, you look hella good or something like that with an arrow by the mirror. I'm like, that's right.
Thanks for the beer.
Oh, yeah, you gotta go.
Yeah, I gotta go on. This is my fourth event tonight.
Yeah.
We'll tell you what, we'll stop by the brewery, then we'll go eat, then we'll come back.
There you go.
Sometimes we have a food truck, but food trucks, you know, sometimes they show us and they don't.
Right. Yeah.
Depending on business, but like I said, you can bring whatever food you want there. So.
I know. I was telling him we could take the train out to San Clemente, and then we don't have to worry about it.
And from train.
And we were telling them.
$5 Uber ride.
Take the train out to San Clemente, and they don't have to worry about it.
Because we're about like 2 miles off of Pico, up away from the coast, so we're like five bucks Uber. It's not bad at all.
Always is.
Always,
Nick. Thanks again.
Pleasure.
Brother. Appreciate it, man.
Absolutely.
Thank you for having me all the time.
Yeah.
Right, dude. We'll talk to you this week, man.
Absolutely. Game nights.
Yep. Have fun. Cool.
Later.
Take it easy.
What is it? Belching Beaver?
Belching Beaver. Belching.
All right.
How do you do
the, all right, guys.
How do you do the Beaver?
Did you get the blit on camera? Yeah. What'd you say?
How do you get the Beaver part?
Oh, God. Go ahead and show us the Beaver.
No!
Alright, guys. Anyways, next week, Thursday night, Belching
Beaver.
Belching Beaver will be here at 6 p.m. giving merch away, free pint glasses for pint night. Just like tonight, come down. We'll see you then. Show us the Beaver.
No!
Oh, man. Alright, stop. Cut. Big, I promise you bars so I could buy a few cars, make a few flows so I could